Hello, and we're back at the game day set with your homecoming king and queen for the Bethany, for Bethany College. Kyle Rocky, how you feeling right now?
Kind of surreal. It's kind of a nice feeling. I feel old, but I'm happy.
And Taylor Lewis, how are you doing?
I'm overwhelmed right now, but this is pretty cool, so.
Now, what made you both want to apply for homecoming court?
I just thought it'd be kind of fun. It's my senior year. I thought it was a good opportunity. I always wanted to be on homecoming court, so thought it'd be a good time.
Yeah, like Rocky said, we were seniors and we wanted to represent the college well, and I'm glad we got the chance. So.
And what are your plans for after you graduate and after college?
I plan to go to grad school for my master's in education to become a school counselor and help kids.
I'm planning to go to grad school to get my doctorate in clinical psychology and become a professor.
Well, it sounds like you both have really bright futures. Thank you for coming on the set, and congratulations.
Thank you very much.
All right, back to you guys.
All right, we're going to send it quickly down to Jocelyn Nelson for an update. Jocelyn?
Thank you, Kyle and Josh. I'm coming at you guys live from the sideline with a bit of an injury report for you. Early in the game, we saw 39 for W&J, Jordan Yates, take a knee injury. After talking with his trainer, he is probable to return later in the game. Also, more recently, we saw number 59 for the Bison, Bo Burtis, take a calf injury. After watching the trainer tape up his ankle, we are assuming that he is also probable to return. Thank you, and back to you, Kyle and Josh.
Oh, another save by Huffman. Huffman's done real well today. She's made 6 or 7 vital saves.
She's very controlled in that goal. She's not really scattered.
She's not frantic at all.
Very controlled.
Very composed. It's another Bethany penalty, though. It's Kanar on the sideline. She's going to move it in. She's got Cunningham. She's got Solomon. Move to the edge as Webster miscontrolled. Baldwin picks it up. Moves it to Vieira. Vieira with the ball inside. It's a melee in there. And it's another Bethany penalty.
And that's where Bethany is losing it, is right when they get into that tight fight right in front of the goal.
And honestly, they just need a bit of luck. If you look at the gopher ball, that ball just trickled over the line. They couldn't have done much about that. It's just luck of the draw at the moment.
They need to get some oomph behind it, really push it in there, make that final shove.
Kanar moves it to the edge. It's controlled by Solomon. She moves it to Snyder.
You can tell they're trying to pass.
And this is
the
danger, the 3-2 right here.
Gophers are way ahead of the Bison.
Look at the speed, and they've got 2-1. Needs a big tackle, and that's a great tackle by Snyder there.
Amazing by Snyder. She had a lot of Gophers coming at her. She needed to be ready for that, and she was. Gave the Bethany Bison some time to reform and get in front of the Gophers again.
So go for foul. The ball is with Shalenko.
And you are very right in making that transition faster, because once they had 4 Gophers out in front of their line, they needed to pick up the speed and really get in front of them.
Well, if it wasn't for Snyder, that would have most likely been a certain goal. So Goucher ball out wide with Shalenko. She moves it into Barminski. It's intercepted by Baldwin, who's having a fine game in there, breaking up the play today. Baldwin trying to find a pass. She hasn't got many options in there.
You can tell she's coming into the second half with some renewed vigor, though. She's ready to go.
That's a great control by Solomon. She moves past one. She's got Cuffy down the right-hand side. She's got Vieira down the left. She moves it to Cuffy. It's a foot violation again.
Solomon really worked that ball down the field. And she's very controlled with her dribbling. Manages to keep that straight line and work past a lot of people in one drive.
Kanar loses the ball. That's Cunningham there. She's got Webster in the middle. She's got Snyder at the back. But the ball is a gopher ball. Shalenko with a restart. Baldwin trying to cut off angles. She is absolutely everywhere today in that center.
Roland is really trying to get in, too. She's definitely putting up more of a fight for the Gophers there, trying to get in the Bison's way.
Miscontrol, unfortunately, there by Cunningham. Shalenko to restart the game. Notice the 10-minute half time has done Bethany well again. Like they're back to that high pressure. Giving look at Cuffy and Solomon straight on her, giving her no chance to move that ball. Rayo working hard to get out wide.
Yeah, they were able to regroup, reorganize, figure out who they needed to watch out for and how to set up them a little bit better so they can hold that defensive line and really push the offense down to the other side of the field.
Well, the key players for the Gophers tonight has obviously been Barminski. Carter had a good first 20 minutes. And then they've also got Rulin, who's actually been causing a lot of problems as well, as she's right there.
Yeah, she did. She was kind of smart staying quiet for that first half of the first half, first quarter there.
Cuffy moves around one, takes on Barminski. Look at the pace. The girl's breezing past them. It's unfortunate that Rayo just couldn't get there. And that's a Kofa ball. And straight away, no hesitation, trying to force him down the field. And this is where the Bison are in trouble. It's very obvious what the Gophers are trying to do tonight. They're just trying to weather the storm when the Bison put high pressure on down the field. And then they're just trying to catch him on that counterattack.
I'm really looking to see something come out of Solomon here, though, because she led the team last year with 6 goals and 14 points. I'd really like to see her stepping up her game here and working towards that goal again.
Well, even though Solomon is just the junior, she is one of the most senior players on the team. It's the thing we need to state is that it's actually a very young team. It's only in its third year. They've just got a new coach. And they've just got a new assistant coach in Ashley Needle, who's a former player of the Bethany Bison field hockey team.
And we saw Solomon and Gill played all 14 games last season, and you can tell how much that experience helped them and how it's elevated them a little bit more. We're really seeing some impressive work from those two.
Cunningham and Fulcy in a Bethany ball.
Bethany trying not to get trapped in that corner there and moving it out closer to the goal.
Once another violation, it's Bethany ball. Cunningham with the restart. 25 minutes remaining in the second half.
And you're seeing Solomon's there ready to back her up if she can just get the ball out of that Gopher line. And the ball goes to the Gophers.
But it just seemed there that Cunningham was just trying to force it in. Instead of trying to find the pass and then making a run off of her player, she was just trying to force that pass a little too much.
Number 6 for the Gophers.
Snyder
really
breaking
up
the play
there
again. Solenko, Solomon hustling, moves it into Barminski, who goes past Gill. Cuffy working back again. Superb work from the girl tonight.
Gill is really working that middle, too. She's getting on top of every girl that has that ball, really keeping a locked vision on it.
She hasn't been off for 1 minute this game. How that girl is not exhausted is beyond me. It's good pressure there from Rayo up against DeLuca. That's a foul against Rayo.
She did a really good job, though, making sure she didn't get that run down the right-hand side of the field.
Sometimes there is such a thing as a smart foul, and the way that the Gophers play, they need to be breaking up the counter-attack. So if that means taking a foul, then they need to do it. That's a shot. That's a great save by McCrary. Webster breaking up the play with Darling. Carter trying to get it going again. She moves through the middle. It's another save by McCrary. It's a fight between Webster and Carter. Gill breaking up the play once again. She's had a fine game this evening.
McCrary really on top of things in that corner.
Oh, she stepped up tonight.
She's been doing a great job in the goal, really working hard. McCrary being a sophomore, you can see where her freshman experience came in.
And that's a Gopher ball out on the right-hand side. It'll be restarted by Barminski. Barminski moves it into the middle. It's intercepted by Gill. Katie Kelly picks up the ball. She's got options to her right and left.
Working down that right side of the field.
Tries to take her on. It's intercepted by DeLuca, and it's broken up there by Darling once again.
Despite the switch of sides, they really, both teams work that right side of the field, that right line.
They do seem to be gravitated towards it for some reason.
And I think that's going to be a defining moment whenever one of them really breaks off of it. Because where all their defense is going right now.
That's intercepted by Cunningham. DeLuca breaks up the play. It's their turn, Morgan Turner putting on pressure, winning the bias and a foul. It's another interception. Bethany just struggling to get out of their defensive third at the moment. They just need to be careful. So it's broken up once again by Webster. That's good work. Gophers had Barminski arriving late. She controls it well. Ball passed behind her. McGray with another save. She just clears it out wide. And that's a sideline ball for the Gophers.
Yeah, that always seems to be McCary's go-to, is just kick that ball as far as she can away from her goal. Get it out of her zone.
Well, it can't be dangerous if it's nowhere near the goal. Rayo moving out wide. She's using that pace. She gives it to Katie Kelly. Katie Kelly tackled by number 23, Cost.